This is the Donald Trump you'll rarely see, home with his wife and his children and grandchildren. A family portrait with his wife, Melania, and their first sit-down interview together since her husband announced his bid for president. Here's ABC's Barbara Walters.
Because our leaders are stupid.
Stupid, stupid people.
Donald Trump is a candidate unlike any other.
Wah. Bing, bing, bong, and dat.
You speak your mind, heaven knows. You have sometimes offended women, Latinos, veterans. How can you unify the country when you make these divisive statements?
Women respect me, they like me, and they know I'm going to take care of them. I'm going to protect them. The people that are here legally, Hispanics, like me because they don't want people coming in and taking their jobs.
Do you speak any Spanish?
No. This is an English-speaking country, remember?
What's the downside of being part of the 1% of the richest people in America, especially when you're trying to reach the middle class?
The funny thing is, I'm a rich guy, but I have this great relationship with the working people of this country, and that's true.
Donald Trump has always set the gold standard, literally, for life at the top. His $100 million tri-level penthouse is inspired by Versailles. You have said that success is a kind of drug, and it's too powerful for most people to handle. How do you handle success?
Well, a lot of people can't handle success. I've seen it. A lot of people can't win. They don't know how to win.
He shares this palace in the sky with his beautiful and graceful wife, Melania.
Hello.
Look who we have.
She has been mostly absent from the campaign trail until tonight.
You too.
Come join us. Mrs. Trump, it's a pleasure to see you, and we don't see you that often. You're not on the campaign trail. How do you feel about campaigning?
Well, it's my choice not to be there. I support my husband 100%, but we have a 9-year-old son together, Baron, and I'm raising him, and this is the age he needs a parent at home.
Were you involved in the decision of your husband to become president?
We discuss a lot, yes, and I encourage him. And
you
I
did? You
I encourage him because I know what he will do and what he can do for America. He loves the American people and he wants to help them.
But if the Trumps win the White House, Melania will have two noteworthy distinctions. The first foreign-born First Lady since John Quincy Adams' wife, Louisa, and the first First Lady to have posed in a picture like this. I don't know how to put this, but your image looking the way you do, is that a liability for your husband?
I don't think so. I don't think so. I think people will always judge. Maybe they will say, oh, the past that you have, the way you were modeling, that's part of the job that I was doing. I was a very successful model.
It's been 10 years since Donald and Melania said, I do, in a lavish affair at Trump's Mar-a-Lago estate in Florida. This is your third marriage. What's different this time?
Well, I think I understand life. I've gone through tremendous amounts of everything, deals and building companies and taking care of
people.
How
does that help marriage?
Well, it hurts marriage because you're working all the time.
Your husband has been married twice before. Did you have any concerns that it might not work out?
No, I didn't have any concerns. We have a great chemistry, and to be with the man as my husband is, you need to know who you are. You need to be very smart and quick and be there for him when he needs you.
Is yours a marriage of equals?
I would say yes.
I would say no. No, I think she's far greater than the 50%. No, we have a very, very pretty much equal relationship,
yes.
Wouldn't you say?
I wondered if Melania had ever taken her husband to task on his tone toward women on the campaign trail.
Did he make a derogatory comment attacking Carly Fiorina?
He said, look at that face, would anyone vote for that?
I think women all over this country heard very clearly what Mr. Trump said.
You know your husband has come under fire here and there for making disparaging remarks about women. Does this bother you?
It doesn't bother me. He treats everybody the same. He talked about men as well, not about the women only. Maybe they just go into a little bit more details when he says something about women.
I sat down with Donald Trump's four oldest children. Donald Jr., 37, Ivanka, 34, Eric, 31, and Tiffany, 22. Has your father ever said anything on the campaign trail that made you cringe?
Truthfully, no.
No, no, no.
He's true to himself, and he speaks in a way that the average person can understand. I think that's refreshing for everyone.
Tiffany, Trump's daughter by his second wife, Marla Maples, is a senior at her father's alma mater, the University of Pennsylvania, with plans to go to law school. Tiffany, people are meeting you today, many people for the first time.
Yes.
To grow up with the name Tiffany Trump,
yes,
that's not easy.
It's all I know. I'm so happy to be Tiffany Trump. I'm so happy to be, you know, in the family I'm in with my siblings and my father and my mother.
They say their father also taught them to respect the value of a dollar.
To say we weren't spoiled would be laughable, but we were spoiled with great education, great experiences, but we weren't the kids showing up to college with, you know, a Ferrari. We always had to sort of earn whatever it is that we wanted.
And, it seems the Donald Trump work ethic is in their DNA.
We refer to it as the Trump guilt. You know, it's when we wake up on Saturday and we're not working.
Your father has said that he was not, I'm using his words, very present when you were growing up.
I would challenge him on that because he was very available to us.
I mean, from when we were 6 years old, I'd call, he'd be negotiating with the CEO of a major bank or whatever it may be, and he would make them wait. He'd take the call from us.
Our times together were learning, you know, playing in his office. He would always sneak me down to get a candy bar, you know, in the lobby.
It's a very different side of Donald Trump, the soft one. Breaking from the daily grind to greet his seven grandchildren.
Look at this, huh? What a troop.
What is your father like as a grandfather?
He's been great.
Seems even the littlest Trumps are already learning from Grandpa.
A few months ago, we're walking down the street, and my daughter sees a large pothole in the middle of a New York City street. And she looks at me and she goes, Mom, Grandpa would not like that. So it's very cute. And she's four. So she's observed him.
Definitely genetics.
Yeah,
definitely
for sure.
Genetic component.
What do you dream about most frequently?
I have good dreams, just having a good life. Good family, good life.
For many, the White House is a step up. I am looking around this room. The White House might be a step down.
The White House is the White House. It's just a spectacular place. And, you know, it's something that represents something very special.
Our thanks to Barbara.